presentation. My name is Odair, and topic is relation between ethyl donors' pronunciation and listening ability at early stage. Let me ask you, how high do you think is the correlation between ethyl donors' pronunciation and their listening ability? Anybody for no? Anybody for high? How about moderate and low? Okay, so moderate and high side is more. The research question, when I was talking about the students listening with my friend, with my colleague, are those who are good at pronunciation in L2 better at L2 listening than those who are not, good or bad? It was my curiosity. Is it just a common sense or is it really? So I did some research to find out the relations between the two. And subjects, 17 students in a team in my school. And they are learning Korean as a foreign language at DLI. And 10 male students and 7 female. And age range, late teens to mid 20s. 7 in teens and 10 in the 20s. For pronunciation, I made students read the first 5 pages of an authentic picture book, and students' reading was recorded. It was in the first week of learning Korean, right after they finished learning how to read Korean alphabet letters. For pronunciation scores, their pronunciation was rated in terms of their fluency, accuracy, and naturalness, like native likeness. For listening comprehension, unit test scores. I used the unit test scores and unit 1, 2, 3 tests. It was done in the 6th week, 9th week, 11th week, respectively. Pronunciation, like I said, they did like that. This is the book, authentic book. Topic, title is Akim Opshi Junun Namu, which is translated as a giving tree in English. First 5 pages, this is the first 5 pages, and text over there. This is the first page, the title, and second page, there's a text. Let me play students reading.
Yetnal Yetnale Yamuhan Gunuga Isasamida.
Yodnal Yodnale Namuhan Garuga Otsimnida.
Yodnal Yodnale Namuhan Guruga Isop Tuhan Samnida.
Like
that. So, second page, third, fourth, fifth, and this is the score. Let me show you. The first page, and students from number 1 to 17 students, and they received that score. So let me play. This student S3 got a perfect score and 7. Let me play that.
Akimopshi Junun Namu.
Oh, this is just a short. Let me play the longer one. Okay, S7, this one is a high score.
Yetnal yetnare namu hanguruga isso simida.
That's very clear. And how about the lowest one?
Yo snav. 옛날 옛날요 남한 누르나 있었습니다.
It's a collapse. It's... How about the middle?
옛날 옛날에 나무 한 그루가 있었습니다.
Okay, these were their reading. So I graded their pronunciation in terms of fluency, accuracy, and native likeness. And the left one is the first rating, and the second one is the second rating. Maybe 2 weeks apart from each rating. And I checked the intra-rater reliability. This is quite high. And highly consistent in time scoring. Okay, listening comprehension. This is the first week I conducted the pronunciation recording. And unit 1 through unit 6, unit 7 is the semester 1. And I considered unit 1, 2, 3 as early stage for unit 1, 2, 3. And this is the pronunciation here. And then listening comprehension scores in unit tests. Unit 1, unit 2, unit 3. And I conversion from the letter grade to number grade. So for A, grade A is 4.0. C is 2.0. F is 0.1. So this is the conversion table. Each student, it's a pronunciation and listening comprehension tests for each units 1 through 3. Analysis. So correlation between pronunciation and combined scores. Combined means achievement test and proficiency test. In Korean school, unit 1 and 2 tests is achievement test, and unit 3 is a proficiency test. And then correlation between pronunciation and only achievement test scores. There were outliers, so I included and excluded for the analysis. And correlation between pronunciation and proficiency tests. Which is unit 3, so I included excluded the outliers. So this is the graph, correlation between combined. So first combined test, I included two outliers. So circle, red circle and blue circle, they are outliers. This is a kind of correlation. And I included these two that I got 0.142. Which is not significant at all. This one, I excluded the outlier S16, which was the red color one, and correlation went up this much, and excluded the next outlier, then correlation went up that much. Which is significant at the level of 0.5 level, P level. And how about correlation between only achievement tests, excluding the proficient test? And I included the outliers, and correlation is quite low. Excluding the first outlier, correlation went up, excluding the two outliers as student 16 and student 4, which went up to this much, which is significant correlation, positive correlation. Next, correlation with proficiency test only. So excluding the outlier because he or she did not take the test. So here is the blank, no score here. So correlation here is moderate. And excluding two outliers, the correlation went up to be significant at 0.05 level. And then I did an additional look at how about extending to semester one, not only unit 1 through 3, how about unit 1 through 7, which is semester one. Correlation with combined, including two outliers, correlation is quite low. Excluding one outlier, correlation went up. Excluding two outliers, the second one, two outliers, S16 and S44, the correlation went up 0.617, which is significant at 0.05 p level. How about with achievement tests only? Including two outliers, correlation very low. And excluding one outlier, went up a little bit more. Excluding two outliers, went up 0.633, which is significantly statistically significant at 0.05 level. How about correlation with proficiency test only, excluding first outlier, 0.454, excluding two outliers, which is 0.553, which is significant at 0.05 level. Okay, this is a relationship sum up. 17 students, all students included, with combined tests this much, with only achievement tests this much, and proficiency test, no. And how about semester one, unit 1 through 7, it's combined achievement test only, proficiency. Because the outlier did not take the test here, that's why. And then 16 students, outlier one excluded. So correlation went up for each relationship. And with two outliers excluded, combined achievement test, proficiency test, combined achievement test, proficiency tests. They are all was the significant at 0.05 level. So, my conclusion. Learner's ability to pronounce the target language has a positive significant effect on their listening ability at early stage in Korean as a foreign learning. Pronunciation must be very important. It's a foundation for listening skills at early stage. Learners and teachers should be aware of the importance of pronunciation and need to improve as early as possible. And further research, how about for different languages, Chinese, Arabic, or how about different stage of learning? Not early stage, maybe middle stage or later stage of learning. How about larger sample size? This is only 17, it's quite a small size. So, this is my conclusion and question.
What's your pedagogical implication then?
pedagogical implication?
Yes, based on your research.
There is. Learners and teachers.
Well,
okay. But this is just a small size, small scale. Right? So maybe for the research, they're collecting more data.
You asked about other languages. I teach Chinese. And
Chinese.
I suspect the same thing. I didn't
same
do
thing.
Research on it, but I noticed the trend. The students who struggle on the pronunciation don't have a good listening score.
Okay.
Then I always wanted to do this research too. But my question is, you have so much to take care of DOI. You have to teach listening, reading, grammar, speaking,
mm-hmm.
and
culture. Well, listening
how
is the toughest skill.
There's simply no time to focus if they need.
But at least we can remind the students of the importance and make them practice a lot.
Well, practice a lot is the key, but it's, without, These people need help.
Yes.
More.
Yes.
Teachers help, but there's simply no time. That's why I asked you about the pedagogy.
But as you see, as soon as you receive the students,
mm-hmm.
you can easily see some students are good at pronunciation. Some don't.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's hard to improve. Yeah, it's very hard.
Yeah.
It's not easy.
No.
So it's our challenge.
I'm sorry, can you go back to the first or second slide where you had the criteria, what you base pronunciation on?
Based on fluency, how fluent,
yeah, fluency.
And how accurate, and how natural, native-like. So I listen to them a lot, over and over again. And holistically, I rated the reading.
I guess I'm having a hard time distinguishing between accuracy and naturalness.
It's hard, but overall, you can kind of.
And when was this? When were the recordings? How early into their program?
In the first week.
First week.
In the first week, right after they finished learning how to read the alphabet letters.
But you took two readings, yes? One, you said you took
two readings.
No,
one reading, but I scored twice.
Oh.
Timed, 2 weeks of time.
Oh. So you listened to them twice. You didn't record them twice.
Listen a lot, but rated twice.
You waited twice? Yeah, okay. You rated them twice.
Yes. Do you have the metrics of your rating?
Metrics?
Yeah, metrics, some kind of criteria.
No. As a native speaker, you listen a lot from the student 1 to the student 7 very many times. And you kind of an impression, this student is quite blah, blah, blah. In terms of that criteria, I don't have any group before. It could be inaccurate if you have a rubric. Oh, this accuracy, this is, I don't know, you can try.
In that early stage, do you prefer to leave the student pronounce even it's wrong, or you read for them sometimes to let them learn to pronounce correctly? You get my question?
I don't get it.
Should I interfere?
Oh, interfere when they pronounce wrong.
Mm-hmm. Or they learn from their mistakes and I leave them alone? Or which one better?
I think we have to correct them, correct the pronunciation mm-hmm. as early as possible. Later on, it's harder.
Yeah, I agree with them because Chinese is tonal. If you don't get it in the beginning, you simply get confused. But I understand that this is a study trying to find a relationship between students' pronunciation and their listening
yes.
score.
Yes.
So he took it in week 1 to show there's a strong correlation,
yes,
between
yes.
the two. Yeah. Yeah, I think week 1 is really early.
Mm-hmm.
But he's showing that there is a strong correlation between the two, as early as possible.
Maybe after 1 week or so, we can tell, you know, which team would be a good team or which team would be a hard team.
About the outliers?
Outliers?
Uh-huh. Outliers. What about their scores?
Mm-hmm.
So their pronunciation is not good.
Oh, let me show you the outliers. Sometimes there are students who we can't understand their behavior. Okay, the red one. The bottom part is the...
Red
one is S16, the first outlier, and blue one S4.
So
you can see the score, pronunciation is quite high, but you need to test this.
I don't know what happened.
That's why it's outlier. We cannot, it's not a good
thing. Because both outliers are, their pronunciation were very good, but the test score was not good.
Maybe he did not put his energy on the test. He wanted to lead the DM.
Listening test?
Listening test.
Unit 1.
Unit 1.
Oh, listening test.
Yeah, F. He got F.
Yeah, but I think it could be different. It could not be parallel because pronunciation is productive test.
Okay.
And this thing is perceptive.
But it's a sound, related to sound.
Okay.
Pronunciation is a sound, and listening is sound.
But there is the listening test to like a comprehension test, not just, you know, right?
Yeah.
Listening
comprehension.
Yeah, that's why.
Yes.
There is the differences, definitely.
If you don't mind, I think I agree with the researcher. I think if you have trouble listening and distinguish the difference of the sounds,
mm-hmm.
then you have trouble in listening
mm-hmm.
and
yeah.
distinguish the meaning
yeah.
of
you cannot
the
sound words
sound
correctly,
part.
Then it's hard to listen to that. But I don't know, I'm not sure about how about the at later stage. If it is true for the later stage, it will be interesting.
I remember you said that we recorded twice or one time?
No, one time.
One time.
And I waited twice.
Okay.
Before the test? Before all the tests?
Before the first
right
yeah, right after the recording.
Okay, at first I got an impression that the evaluation includes not only the purely the pronunciation part, but also it includes the sensibility of the reading ability.
Reading ability.
Yeah, right. That's somehow involved. The way
but,
you collect the data is.
But it's week one. They don't develop the target language reading skill yet. They just finished the reading, how to read the Korean alphabet letters. That's it.
Have you thought about what caused the correlation?
What caused the correlation?
My assumption is that there are errors in pronunciation. Those mispronounced words kind of fossilize in their memory, and then they perceive
How about you guys? Your English pronunciation.
My English pronunciation is not really good, but I'm good at reading.
Good at reading.
Yeah.
But how about listening?
Listening is not bad.
Not bad. It's quite good. I think you are good at pronunciation and listening too.
I found that among the samples that you saw, something interesting was some students showed very low fluency, but the sound recognition part of me was pretty
clear,
right?
Clear.
Some of them have good pronunciation, but just I think the person in the sample just struggled with the
reading,
recognizing the syllables, right? While they still have good sound recognition skill, right?
Mm-hmm.
So,
that's
yeah. So I think this the data collection includes maybe the reading ability too, not only the pronunciation part.
Mm-hmm.
So somehow it's involved.
Yeah.
That was my
maybe just spontaneous talking, speaking, not reading the written text, just
So maybe we
speaking
need to
yield a different result.
So
okay.
Maybe we can just turn some native script's voice and then let them
yeah.
follow after the sound. And maybe you might have
you can study, you know, maybe app
next time.
In the second semester, later in first semester,
should.
You can record their, you know, natural speaking. Yeah. Five minutes, but I
you look very good.
Anybody who knows about this type of research relations between these two, just let me know.
Okay.
I didn't have time to, you know, research.
Yeah.